For more videos on people's struggles, please subscribe to our YouTube channel.
We are here to protest, do a silent dharna against the upcoming hanging of four people whose daya yachikas have also been refuted by the court.
The issue is that any such hanging is done in the name of society, and we happen to be members of that society who wish to at least record for posterity the fact that there were some people who believed that hanging, no matter whose, is something which in every civilized society should abhor.
There is absolutely no evidence that death penalty has worked as a deterrent, because the roots of the crime are different. I mean, it's deeply rooted in society. So I think in a way it's deviating attention on from what should be the real task.
When you have death penalty for rape, it makes it seem that that there is no life after rape. And what we're increasingly finding is that it's not just rape and murder that people are talking about. It's that rape and you kill in return for somebody being raped, then the only punishment is to kill the rapist, just lynch the person. So in which case you're saying that for women that there is no life after rape, that this is what, it's revenge, so it's life for life, that's the idea.
Every civilized society should give up a punishment that cannot be, that's irreversible, a punishment that does not allow for correcting of any wrong that may happen, a punishment because of its finality of this kind is one that is sure to be misused, a punishment that is sure to have very serious ramifications based on caste, class, gender, and all kinds of inequalities in society. So we find poor people, people who did not have good legal help, are the only people, or those who are seen as political undesirables, are the people who end up going to the news.
I think the laws are there, but it's actually to ensure that they need to be implemented, ensure implementation. And I think that's where societal attitudes of the executive, right? So this feeling of so I think it's very, very fundamental. I think even if existing laws are implemented more rigorously, duly, regardless of who the accused are, regardless of whether the accused is powerful, well-connected, whatever, so I mean, I think that would be really important.
But I do think that as far as the state is also concerned, it's not like it's going to punish everyone who is guilty of rape. And there's so many instances, you think about Kunan Pushpora, or even that Kuldeep Sengar, what it's taken to even get him arrested and convicted. That her father had to die and her aunts had to die. So it is also that, the punishment is also something which is, reproduces social inequalities.
You're not able to ensure a society where law is equally applied or implemented. And in that kind of instance, to actually go for the final punishment and death, and it can only fulfill some kind of feeling that action is being taken, but actually it's not.
So we're not just talking about gender and gender justice. It's also that who is the woman who's raped? Okay, who's the rapist? So all of that also decides crime and punishment there.
Therefore, this spectacle really looks worse. If you look at it in its entirety, it looks worse than it actually is here. It's a bizarre thing that we are teaching our next generation, our kids. We are trying to tell them that four murders are an answer to one murder.
Yeah. Yasin.